just in case you have no idea what's going on. Today we're going to build a solar generator without batteries. That's right. So basically for the project we're going to use the solar charge controller, a 600 watts pure sine inverter. Everything is going to go inside this box right here. We are also going to use USB sockets and the heart of the project. We're going to use super caps. There you go, guys. It's done. Check it out. A solar generator using super caps and no batteries. We have a charge controller. As you can see, we have 8.2 voltage on the caps. And we also have this little one over here. And the cool thing is that I can just switch it off. And right now, disconnected everything. If I switch it back on, that's it. I actually made a test a few weeks ago and I actually ran a whole LED light bulb like this one for half an hour using one row of capacitors. Right now it's 8 volts, it's coming 5 volts from here, but the goodness is I could continue using this light bulb until I just drain the whole capacitor and there's not going to be any damage on the system. It's pretty sunny today, and now we're going to do some real tests. We're going to connect this to the panels. I'm going to use two panels, 200 watts in total, and we're going to run a bunch of stuff with this. Let's go. So I have two panels right now connected out there in front of my house, and let me just fix this. And the voltage, as you can see over here, it's 14.5, 14.4. And we have a solar generator. Now, here's the cool thing. Let's put it to a test, shall we? Inverter is on. I don't see any change. Let me see if this works. There you go. So let me get the Dremel, which I have over here. It's amazing when you turn on all the way up, the voltage drops down to 14.3. That's it. Now it's back on to 14.5. This is so awesome. This is why I wanted to build this. When we got hit by Maria, no one could actually ship batteries. It's so expensive to ship them. But between those caps, I only paid like $70-something. And I can actually turn on a fridge. And if you don't believe me, I'm going to do that in a moment. But this is why I love this technology so much and this whole idea. Of course, it's not going to work during the night. But I have some ideas that we could actually build some stuff to recharge the caps and at least get some decent lights. So this is an emergency kind of deal, which means that we can actually help more people with something so small like this. So we have what? Probably $50 or $60, $70 on the caps, $200 on the panels. And I think we can run a bunch of stuff. So let me get something else. So I think my skills are dead. Oh yeah, it's dead. Okay, let's see how my... I really forgot the name. Okay, let's see how this router works. Okay, that hurt the machine. It dropped down to 12.2, and we don't have a full sunlight on top of the panel, so I really like this test. So of course I didn't build this just to make sure I could run my power tools. If I wanted to do that, I just use batteries. But let's say people just want to turn on a fridge. Right away, it turned on the fan. The voltage dropped down to 13.3, but the fridge, it's on. I can actually feel the fridge vibrating, which is the compressor that I had in. The voltage is coming up. So this is why it's so important to me to build something like this. For less than $400, we can actually turn on a fridge like this one, some lights, charge cell phones, and you don't have to spend a fortune to do this. Yes, of course, it's not gonna work during the night, but you can actually recharge some batteries during the day, and that way you can actually use it for, I don't know, something else. But during the day, you can turn on a fridge. This fridge is going to run until there's nothing coming from the panels or from the cap. I'm not going to be done with this project. This is like the first part of the research and development series. On the next project, I'm going to try to tackle how to build a hand crank generator so we can actually use this during the night. Leave a comment, let me know what you guys think. But like I said, I think this is an amazing opportunity to test stuff like this, you know, to go out there and try to build something that's gonna bring power to a lot of families around the world. This is the 1,000 subscriber celebration project. And let's see what type of project we could build when we hit 2,500, okay?